Hey guys, what is up? Chris here with Koi's Friendship Unit. Just me today. What a big day for video games, basically. What a big day for Sony. We're going to be talking about the PlayStation 5 reveal. Actually, I have a lot to say. This is basically going to be my quick hot take impressions of what went down today for about an hour and 15 plus minutes. I want to talk about how Sony basically is doing things right at the moment and how it's going to be an interesting holiday season, but before we get into all that, we do have a PlayStation 5 reaction reveal. If you haven't seen it yet, you can check it out, and we are doing a PlayStation 5 discussion, which will be up later today, if not tomorrow. So hey, that's a reason to consider subscribing, and we will be having plenty more PlayStation 5 as well as Xbox One X content on this channel. But first, I mean, let's talk about what we saw. So right off the bat, here was my biggest problem with the last Xbox event, where they claimed that they were showing, you know, the first time that you would see Xbox Series X gameplay. And the problem with that particular event was a lot of the games that they were focusing on, this idea of you buy your game on Xbox One today, and then when you buy a Series X, you can migrate it over. So the result of that was a lot of the games were basically not next-gen games. They were games that could be played today, and yes, you can play them at a higher fidelity, higher frame rate, etc. But I think the thing that really stings about how they presented it, right, you're streaming it on YouTube, is one, you're not streaming it at 4K, two, there's YouTube compression artifact, three, you're definitely not streaming it at 120 frames per second, so you lose a lot of the benefits of Xbox Series X when you're trying to advertise the Xbox Series X using old gameplay, which is, that I think that is ultimately kind of what hurt them. Here we have Sony coming in hot, and I mean, like, this was as close to an E3 press conference as you could hope for, or like an E3 presentation. This is probably the closest thing we're going to get, honestly. And what they did was, not only did they show games, right? So I was really like harping on Microsoft. I said, we need games that can only be played on next gen. We need to see, you need to give us a reason to buy these consoles. And that's exactly what Sony did. And they did it in a number of ways. The first way they did it was just by having a shitload of games, quite frankly. And they didn't even mention the PS4. Like, literally did not even talk about it, which I think is a good thing. Keeps focus on the PS5. I mean, this is mostly, that was more of like a marketing thought than like an actual thought about the console. But yeah, they did a good job like laser focusing in on PS5. They did a good job showing what the console was capable of by showing PS5 games. These aren't cross-gen games. I mean, some of them might be, like NBA 2K21 wouldn't surprise me if there's a PS4 version of that, but they were laser focused on high fidelity games, which was great. So not only did they show games that can only be played on PlayStation 5, and we got to kind of see some of the things, like the ray tracing on the new Ratchet and Clank, things like that, but they also showed a lot of first-party games, which is something that Microsoft has decided not to do until July, which they're kind of going for the slow and steady wins the race approach, and Sony seems to be doing this single sprint. I mean, there's going to be a lot more Sony events, but I mean, Microsoft showed off the console at the Game Awards, took a long break, then they did the gameplay reveal, taking a break till July, then they're going to do first party. Sony kind of did everything at once, which in my opinion is really good for building hype, at least in this immediate moment. So yeah, they showed a lot of first party games, ranging from Ratchet and Clank to Spider-Man to Demon's Souls Remake, and I think what's most interesting about that, and there were plenty more games, there were a ton of games ranging from third party to indie, what I think was kind of the biggest takeaway for me as far as the games is that we kind of know what's gonna be pitted up against what come holiday season. It's gonna be Halo Infinite, cross-gen game, versus Spider-Man, which is coming out on PS5. That's gonna be, those are in my opinion both basically killer apps, and I think Spider-Man's a huge killer app because it reaches past the video game audience, right? That like touches people who are not necessarily into video games or casually into video games. So I think that's like, it's gonna be a tough fight, and I think they're both gonna be really, really good games that I'm really excited about. And then we have the console itself. Man, that thing looks weird. Like I said, you can see my reaction of it, and I'm sure in our discussion later tonight, we'll have a lot more to kind of piece apart. But that is the thing that, as they were going through kind of the slow shots of the curvature and all that, reminded me a lot of like a PS3-esque shape, like the original, like thick, fat one, but they kind of like cut out pieces of it in a way. It's an interesting design. It's a bold design. That's where I'm standing right now. I'm sure in the discussion later we'll have a lot more to say about the design, but that's a bold design. And it's interesting to see that they've already basically come out and said that they are going to have two SKUs. It's heavily rumored that Microsoft is going to have two SKUs. They're basically saying, look, we have the disc version and the discless version. They didn't at all elaborate if there is actually a difference in like processing power between the two, but it is something to note that like right off the bat, there's already two versions of the console, presumably on day one. And that's kind of, there's a lot to talk about, right? Like at the end of the Microsoft one, all there was to talk about was where were the games, where was the gameplay, where was the first party stuff. Here, I mean, we're gonna have a whole huge discussion about, we actually planned to have a discussion for the last Microsoft one, but we just didn't warrant enough to say. Now, I mean, there's just so much to talk about. I think PlayStation did a really good job showing this off, even if they really teased us till the last minute, but they had a, this is what matters for consoles, right, guys? Like, they had a great lineup of third-party indie and first-party games. They have a killer app at launch, being Spider-Man, at least. I mean, we don't know about Horizon Zero Dawn, we don't know about other games, but they have at least one really solid game to get you to buy this on day one. And they have, as far as we're aware, decent hardware. The only thing we don't know now is the date and the price, which, I mean, that's kind of the big elephant in the room for both of these guys. It will be curious to see who comes out first, who comes out shooting first, and how the other will react. But if you want our opinions on that, maybe consider subscribing. Let us know down below how you felt about the PlayStation event. That's all for me, and I will catch you next time.